During the evaluation of your child today, what we'll be doing is we'll be taking a STARscan image of their actual skull shape. The STARscanner is a 3D laser scanner that takes an outside photograph of your child's head shape. It's not like an X-ray or a CT scan. It does not emit any kind of radiation or there is no harm to your child. It's actually a class 1 laser, and a child can have a STARscan image taken over and over and over again. It's very safe for them. I often tell parents that it's very similar to the scanner at the grocery store that scans your groceries. What we'll be doing is we will be taking a stockinette and putting it over your child's head just to flatten out the hair so we can actually take a good look at the skull shape. And then we'll be laying the child in the scanner. The scan takes less than 2 seconds, so it's very fast. You'll be with your child the whole time, and then we'll pick the child up and the image will be completed. Basically what happens is the laser takes a quick outside shot of the child's head shape, and then the data gets fed right to the computer, and so we'll be able to look at it today and evaluate your child's skull asymmetry and discuss a treatment plan. Before we had the STARscanner, the way that we would do this is we would take a number of hand measurements of your child's head, which is often very challenging with a wiggly baby, and then we would do a plaster casting of the skull. The plaster casting would involve about a 15 to 20 minute process where we would lay strips of plaster over the child's head and really try to get a really good image and a good impression of your child's current head shape. So now that we have our STARscanner, we do not need to do the casting method, and we'll just do a quick 2 second scan, and we'll have all that information that we need to actually fabricate a cranial remolding helmet if we need to. The other great advantage of the STARscanner is we're able to look at all the measurements of your child's head shape today, and we're actually able to look at them over a continuum of time, and we're able to see, does the head shape improve over time? Does it get better? Does it get worse? What's happening? And so it's often a tool that we use to make treatment decisions on what's going on with your child and their head shape.